Alright, so as you probably know, the pencil tool can do a few different things, such as write new MIDI notes, as well as write automation. So if I go into the automations lane, I can right click the pencil tool and choose freehand and draw automation. Now, this is not affecting the original file itself because it's not a destructive action, right? We just drew automation in the automations lane. By the way, these files are the same. The green one is just a duplicate of the blue one. Right, so what if we decide to really zoom into our file and draw this very bizarre shape right here? Notice how the original file also got altered. But what happens when I remove a bit of the green file? Nothing happens to the original one because that is not a destructive action, as opposed to redrawing the waveform using the pencil tool. So that's always something good to be aware of. So let's play back and check out what happened. For this one, I suggest you to lower the volume of your speakers or headphones, just in case.
Nessa cama.
So you can hear there is a gigantic click right here, right? And also, when you go back to Finder and play back the mouth clicks file, that was around 55 seconds. So let's go around there as well.
Nessa cama.
So you can hear that the click happens on the original file as well. And also, notice how the file got modified at 11:23, exactly 2 minutes ago. So without having to save the project or export the file to a new one, our original file got modified. So that's always something to be very careful about. Fortunately, we can avoid this by not only duplicating the file, but also consolidating it to a new one. So let's do that by Shift Option 3 and just renaming this to Consolidated. Consolidated. All right, so now we are good to move on. So let's just get rid of this. We don't need to hear this, do we? So what we're gonna do is try to identify the clicks. Now the clicks are essentially ticks or pops that we can hear when we speak, something like this. All right, so let's play back and check out what is going on.
Nessa cama tinha uma avó. Nessa cama tinha uma avó.
So you can hear that there is a lot of clicks happening in this area right here. So the best way to find them is by clicking on your scrub tool and just sliding it across the file. So we're looking for, again, little ticks or pops that will help us identify where the clicks are located. This is one of them. And these two are also clicks. So let's just put a marker there. Say 1, 2, and 3. Right, so zooming in, we can notice that right here you have this little deformity. You can see that previous to it, the waveform shape is very uniform. It flows just as a sine wave. That's exactly what we need to reproduce here as well. So let's dive deep into it, grab the pencil tool, freehand, and redraw the waveform, try to match the flow of the other ones. Right, so let's hear that. And it's gone. So as compared to the original, there's a click there. And now we have no clicks. Let's move on to 2 and 3. Now this one, you can see a little bit from afar that there's this tick popping out of the waveform. That's our click. You can also check this out right here. That's massive. So let's begin with number 2 now. Let me zoom in a little bit here. Now pencil tool, freehand. Now we don't need to actually redraw just as it is here, but try to really continue with the flow, right? Let me just So that's one. Let's go to number three. That's two, actually. Let's go to number three. And let's check it out. And our clicks are gone. Let's compare them from the start. So this is the new one.
Nessa cama tinha uma avó. Nessa cama tinha uma avó.
So you can see there is a massive difference already, right? So let's go back to the new one.
Nessa cama tinha uma avó.
So as you can see, the pencil tool can deliver very good results. Of course, it's not perfect. You can't really dive into a syllable and remove a thump or a massive click. For that, I think you'll be better off by using a spectral editor. However, if you don't have access to these tools, the pencil tool can be very handy. Now, just remember to always duplicate the file and consolidate it to a new one. Otherwise, you're going to be altering the original file without ever having to export the file to a new one. Anyways, I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any further questions, please let me know down in the comments. It really helps, not only myself, but also you and the community. Other than that, I wish you have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon. See ya!